Hello, this is Dr. Tom with a presentation on NCEES problem number 28. It's on the adiabatic efficiency of open systems. So let's get started. Okay, this NCEES solution has been a source of many questions by many of the previous participants. The confusion seems to be is that the given diagram of the fan and the compressor do not show clearly that there are two paths for the air, one through the compressor and one through the fan or around the compressor. The NCEES had an errata back for the 2016 edition, which I think helped to resolve the confusion. However, the new 2019 edition has a different diagram that I think gives the impression that the air from the exit of the fan goes into the inlet of the compressor, which it does not. Both the fan and the compressor see the same inlet conditions, and that's going to still be a confusion. And the NCEES solution reflects that constant specific heats were used, but that should have been stated explicitly, and it was not. Okay, the problem asks for a total input power required to drive both the fan and the compressor. That can be calculated from the sum, the power W dot of the fan plus the W dot of the compressor, where the W dot is M dot difference in the enthalpies, H2A minus H1. However, for constant specific heats, the change in the enthalpy can be replaced by constant pressure specific heat times the change in temperature, Cp delta T. And the adiabatic efficiencies, they are given for both of them, not the exit conditions. So the change in the temperature for the constant specific heats can be expressed as, if you take the adiabatic efficiency equation and solve for T2A minus T1, you end up with T2S minus T1 over the given adiabatic efficiency. Therefore, the power for either the fan or the compressor can be expressed as M dot Cp times T2S minus T1 over the adiabatic efficiency. We're given T1, so we need just T2S. Okay, for fan or the compressor and for constant specific heats where K is equal to 1.4, we can solve for T2S. We're given the ratio of the pressures between the fan and for the compressor, so we can do that to find our T2S. So for the fan, we've got the T1, again, got to use absolute, 540 degrees Rankine. The pressure for that is 1.3. Raise it to the K minus 1 over K and get 582 degrees Rankine. If we now put that into the equation for the power fan, W dot of the fan, M dot Cp times the T2S minus T1 over eta, which is the efficiency, we've got the given 400 pounds per second, the Cp 0.24 BTUs per pound mass per degree Rankine, our degrees Rankine 582 minus 540, and then 0.85 is the adiabatic efficiency. If we look at all of our units here, we will end up with pound masses cancel. We have BTUs per second, degrees Rankine cancel. So we do end up with BTUs per second. Well, we can convert the BTUs to foot pounds, and that'll give us foot pound seconds and one horsepower to 550 foot pound seconds. So that gives us about a little over 6,700 horsepower. Okay, and that's for the fan. Okay, for the compressor, we can do the same thing. It has, again, the same inlet condition, T1, 540, but its pressure ratio is 10 to 1, so we end up with 1,043 degrees Rankine for its T2S. So if we put that in the equation, and we now know the units work out, so we'll get 14,202 BTUs per second, then do our conversion and get a little over 20,000 horsepower. So now we add those two together and get 26,800 horsepower, and that is answer B. Okay, well, that concludes the presentation. As always, we appreciate you allowing us to help you prepare for this exam.